Absolutely ludicrous. It just really bugs me to no end. Now, moving on here just a little, I want to speak about House Speaker Pelosi unveils $2.5 trillion Democrat coronavirus stimulus plan as Senate bill stagnates. Well, the Senate bill stagnated because it didn't have all of the extra goodies in it that the Democrats shoved in. Now, I've been told that this particular package here wasn't quite as chock full of Nancy Pelosi's pet projects she had in. But some of the things that I've read that's involved in this, 1,400, look at that. Pelosi's 1,400-page bill. You know how long it takes to read 1,400-page bill? Well, that's one of the things they're counting on. See, you got to shove in as much as possible. You got to shove in more than what you want. So you're going to get a bunch of what you want. And if you work it just right, you're going to be able to skim a whole lot right off the top and put it in your own pocket. And don't tell me these politicians won't do it. Don't even try to tell me they won't do it. There's a whole bunch of money in there that they're looking at with a lot of greed in their eyes, foaming at the mouth. Again, you know, you're going to have different places that are going to report different aspects of what's actually included in the bill. So do your homework. Dig it out for yourself. Again, one of the things I should have put in the very beginning of the program, don't listen to me. Don't take my word for nothing. I'll give you some information, but you need to get out there and prove it for yourself. Because I don't want nobody blaming me. I don't want nobody holding me accountable. Go out there and do your homework. It's all right available there for you. But some of the things that I've heard in this that are just, it boggles the mind. Ted Cruz from Texas, Ted Cruz had a good floor speech the other day. And he was going through and naming off a lot of things that they had included. And he was like, Mr. President, what in the hell does this have to do with coronavirus? What in the hell does this have to do with struggling families and businesses? It's all pork. It's government pork, political pork. And we are in a period of time where a majority of what I'm discussing is pork, is from the Democrat side. That's not to say Republicans don't do it at other times when it's politically convenient. They do. This particular bill, excuse me, again, I'm trying to learn how to use this software, so please forgive me for moving around here and trying to grab a hold of everything. I run across this on Twitter. Joy Reid, host of MSNBC. I don't know what program. I don't watch NBC, MSNBC. So I don't know how long she's there, what her interests are, what her political leanings are, although I think I got a pretty good clue. But anyhow, here's one of her complaints. Why did the Republican bill contain a $500 billion slush fund? You like the way that's worded? Did she say what it was? How do we know it's a slush fund? She just throws that out there. But I will say this much. If the Republicans did have a $500 billion slush fund in there, then I see that as problematic as well. I don't care where the pork is. I don't care where the pork is on a bill like this. People are hurting. People are suffering. Families are suffering. Small businesses are sincerely suffering. And people are dying. This isn't the time to, you know, get political favors. This isn't the time to pad your pocket. But again, this lady's talking about this $500 billion thing, slush fund. Well, in the first place, it's pork. If it's pork, it needs to go, Republican, Democrat, or otherwise. Why should Secretary Mnuchin have control of such a fund without the American people being able to know who got the loans until after the election? Well, as to the first part of that, does this woman not understand what it means to be Secretary of the Treasury? Who put him in charge? He's the Secretary of the Treasury, you know, money. That's what kind of the way that it works. I don't remember her. I don't remember her saying anything about, what was his name, Timothy Geithner, under Obama. Holy crap. Now, he might not have been Treasury Secretary. He might have been head of the IRS. I forget exactly which, but, oh my God. No, he should have never been there. You talk about a do-boy. But again, with all of the stuff that the Democrats shoved into the package, here, all she can come up with is partisan arguments. All she can come up with is partisan arguments. And the first one is open-ended because she doesn't explain what the $500 billion slush fund is. So that's just getting a little overrated, but that is what we've learned to expect from the left. Now, another thing that I wanted to go into here is the longer that this drags out, the more pressure it's going to put on a lot of people. And the longer you force people to go without earning an income, and the longer you force them to be able to endure a period of not being able to pay their bills, not being able to stay updated with everything, well, crime goes a little on the nuts side. Now, it says March 3rd here was the date this was put out. However, the robbery happened on February 25th. Four armed men rob a pharmacy on Cleveland, Ohio's east side. Do you think they took drugs to help people with the coronavirus? No. Narcotics, money, you know, just ridiculous. And this ain't the only incident like this. I found another one. This happened in Pennsylvania just the other day, updated March 22nd. Four armed masked men rob pharmacy and steal more narcotics. Where were concealed weapons holders during these? See, I'm sorry, in a pharmacy, there should be somebody there that is a concealed carry. I think they should have one in every pharmacy. These guys should have been plugged. I know that's probably bad of me to say, but I think they should have been taken down. This is going to get bad. This is going to get a heck of a lot worse the longer this thing drags out. I know they've had the law in California for a while, but I believe it was somewhere in Pennsylvania. Don't quote me on that. But somebody in another state recently passed a law to where the police are not going to be as vigilant. They're not going to send out units for crimes that are $1,000 or under. California is proving how stupid that is. 30 people run into a department store, grab an armload each, and haul ass out the door. Nobody's allowed to stop them. Call the police. So, you know, that's the way that it goes. You know, I'm sure whichever way they get into it, they could probably deduct these things under taxes. And I'm sure that's some of the placating reason for, oh, well, you know, it happened, so just deal with it. But this has to be stopped. This is encouraging crime. And another thing with this coronavirus, holy shit, we're releasing thousands of convicts across the country. Thousands. Remember how many of you complained about all those ones Obama let loose? Well, here we go with more. So I had a couple things left here. Oh, this one's interesting. Coronavirus stimulus offered by House Financial Services Committee, chaired by Maxine Waters. God help her. Coronavirus stimulus offered by House Financial Services Committee creates a new digital dollar. I'm going to say more than 2 years ago, I started telling people or warning people against Bitcoin and these other digital currencies because it's a threat in many ways to governments and their piece of the pie. So here, now this article does go on to say that this is no longer part of the stimulus, but the article also goes on to say that the language is still there. I'm still trying to figure that one out. But they want to create their own digital currency to protect the almighty U.S. dollar, to squash all of these other digital currencies out of existence. Just more of the leftist, elitist, statist, draconian measures that you can imagine. And some other things here. Let's see, where is it at? Oh, yeah. One other thing I did want to talk about here is there's a lot of people out upset because of the National Guard being called into action around the country. And there's a lot of people, whether it's your preppers or your survivalists or your anti-New World Order people, they're all on edge. Oh, God, here we go. We're going into martial law. Well, let me give you just a little.